against the peace and dignity of the state. This is charged with an aimless conviction for this offense was carried with it up to a year in jail up to $2,000 in fines or fines. You're represented here today by Attorney McKinnon.
Yes.
You understand, sir, that anything you say can and will be used against you?
Yes.
Counsel, what is his intention to ask for plea this morning?
Good morning, Your Honor. My client intends to plead guilty this morning.
Mr. Bullock, I have a document in front of me entitled Acknowledgement of Waiver of Rights for eight misdemeanors. Have you seen such a form, sir?
Yes, sir.
Did you have the opportunity to go over the form with your attorney?
Yes.
Did your attorney answer any and all questions you had about anything on this form, sir?
Yes.
You understand knowing, come forth, or make you plead guilty?
Yes.
You understand that you have every right to have a trial, the right to contest this case?
Yes.
And you understand you're giving up that right here this morning?
Yes.
When you do so, sir, you can have all the rights in the gray or shaded area of the form?
Yes.
Have you reviewed those rights with your attorney?
Yes.
Do you have any questions of me about those rights?
No.
You understand them?
Yes.
You understand on a plea of guilty, you're admitting you committed this offense?
Yes.
Has any force, threat, or pressure been applied to you in order to make you do so?
No.
According to this form, sir, there is going to be a recommended sentence. Also understand I'm not bound by that recommendation?
Yes.
And if I decide I do cannot go along with it, you could back out of your plea and have a hearing before another judge?
Yes.
And I'm satisfied with the services of Mr. McKinnon?
Yes.
Counsel, when you review the form of your client, are you satisfied he knows when he's changed the rights you'll be giving up?
Yes, Your Honor. I'm under the impression that my client is knowingly and voluntarily waiving his rights.
Mr. Bullock, are you giving up all these rights of your own free will, sir?
Yes.
Can I have a motion approved, please?
Yes, Your Honor. On the 27th of September of this year, Harvey Bullock had visited the complainant at her residence to assist with a water shortage problem that Bethlehem. And the complainant alleged that he gave her a hug, she felt uncomfortable and pulled away, and then as she's getting away from him, he forcibly slapped her on the buttocks. And then she reported this to the police department.
Counsel? You take no issue with the facts as presented, Your Honor.
Based upon the offer of proof of making a finding of guilty for recommendation, please.
Must end the agreement to outline this penalty assessment.
Counsel, anything that you'd like to say about the state's recommendation?
No, Your Honor. I think this matter is one of the implied consent. And as the Supreme Court said in Burke in April of 2006, even a push can be a simple assault if there is no consent to accept that push. And therefore, I've explained that to my client. He has no criminal record. He now understands that slapping someone on the buttocks is inappropriate and does constitute an assault under the law of New Hampshire.
Mr. Brock, would you please answer? On your plea of guilty, sir, I make a finding of guilty and vote to find a $250 plus a $50 penalty assessment. You're going to need to see the clerk about payment of the fine, please. Thank you.
Thank you, Your Honor.
Kevin Zilda. Nine, 9 states that the undersigned complaints that Kevin